Hi, Jim Gore from Thor Investment Management. Our clients and those that have been following us the last several years know that we were negative on Europe a few years back, and we actually had a short of the euro. We actually got rid of that short of the euro when the European central banks saved Europe with their negative interest rates. How did it save Europe? Was the fact that countries were able to take their high interest rate debts, refinance those debts at negative interest rates. In other words, instead of paying interest on their debt, they were actually being paid to sell their bonds. Well, what happened just at the end of May changed that landscape dramatically. And what changed it was the election in Italy of two parties that are now want to spend more money. And they're also not only want to spend more money, they're asking the European Central Bank to forgive 250 billion euros of their bonds that they own and just say that they didn't exist. Well, let's see how that impacted the market in Italy. This is a chart looking at the one-year yields, the yield of the one-year treasury note in Italy. And you can see it was actually negative until the election. It actually went up, skyrocketed to 1%. It went back down almost to zero, and today is actually a little bit higher than it was right after the election. We believe that the reason why it fell down was the European Central Bank coming in and buying some of those bonds. Why do we say that? Well, they have a bond buying program in Europe where the central bank now owns 20% of Italy's debt. That 20% of their debt is pretty substantial. This is not Greece. Italy has 2.3 trillion euros of debt outstanding. So any increase in interest rates is going to be could be possibly devastating to Europe. Well, Italy, we think, is a problem and is going to cause more volatility in the near future. But we think Mario Draghi is going to do what he can as an Italian to protect Italy and to protect the European Union. So he's going to continue to buy bonds from Italy in order to bring down those rates. We don't see that changing until next year when he is termed out, and we're probably going to have Jens Weidmann from the Bundesbank take over. And Germans think of money a lot differently than Italians do. And we think next year is when there's going to be a lot of fireworks. However, in the meantime, Italy is going to cause some volatility around the globe with their interest rates fluctuating the way that they are. Someone without any protection against that volatility in their portfolio should think twice about having some protection and having some things in their portfolio that will reduce the volatility that we think is going to occur over the next couple months.